the Tibetan People's Uprising against the occupying Chinese army. In March 1959, Tibetans from all these provinces rose up against the overwhelming firepower of the Chinese army to protect Tibet's freedom, culture, and its religion. Today is not a day of shame or defeat. It is a day on which the Tibetans stood up against the Chinese with the courage and conviction to proclaim that the Tibetan government and His Holiness the Dalai Lama are their sole protectors. By sacrificing their lives for our cause, the Tibetan heroes have made these facts clear, and as we deeply remember this day, it is important not only to remember them, but also to fulfill their aspirations. From 1959 to this day, there have been three principal slogans: Free Tibet, Long Live His Holiness the Dalai Lama, and China Out of Tibet, which have been chanted by Tibetans both inside Tibet and in exile. These watchwords are a source of strength for the living and final words spoken by those who have died for our cause. We would like to remind everyone that the truth of our struggle, the strength of our unity, proof of our history, and our aspiration are stored deep inside these words. There is something remarkably impactful when truth becomes the rally call for a movement. Martin Luther King Jr. said that the truth crushed to earth will rise again. Henceforth, no matter how much we Tibetans are being oppressed, there will always be this struggle for truth that must come out, should come out, and will come out. The 27 self-immolators to date have taken up this struggle for truth by engaging in a selfless act, not for desperation, nor blind and fruitless action, but for a new and bold protest based on fervent belief in our freedom struggle, taken up by the young generation. Whereupon, they have put themselves on fire to demonstrate the grave injustice committed by the communist Chinese government. Whereupon, they have given their lives not for a desire they strive to attain, but for something similar to what Sopa Rinpoche, a renowned religious figure who self-immolated on January 8, 2012, said, "I am not self-immolating for my personal interest or problems, but for the 6 million Tibetans who have no freedom and for the return of His Holiness the Dalai Lama to Tibet." And just so recently, three Tibetans have killed themselves, demanding for the same rights. They have self-immolated one after the other as they were sparking the chain of revolutionaries, sending out a clear message that a free Tibet is possible. Can you imagine waking up one day and finding out that your mother has killed herself for freedom struggle, leaving behind her 4 kids, then going to sleep and waking up the next morning and hearing your 19-year-old sister had killed herself for the struggle while the people in the local Chinese market were throwing stones at her while she was on fire? Then waking up the morning after and finding out that your 18-year-old brother had killed himself for believing in a just cause. What is this cause that they died for? The cause that enables three Tibetan hunger strikers to sit in front of the United Nations in New York for 18 days without food, just appealing the United Nations and the international bodies who have turned blind eyes to their fast and the situation inside Tibet. United Nations, an organization that supposedly stands for advocating human rights, promoting peace, prevent conflict, and making the world a safer place, as quoted in their own website, has failed to execute every part of it when it comes to Tibet and Tibetans. It is as though Tibet is burning and United Nations is sleeping. If you could make a difference to improve the situation inside Tibet, simply signing a petition wouldn't be enough. We therefore encourage everyone present here to please stand up for Tibetan cause. Now again, you might ask, what is this cause that they all died for? It is the truth, the deep conviction that no matter what all the propaganda, Chinese lies, the truth will rise again from the ashes of our loved ones. Their spirits will rise again. We as Tibetans will rise again, and Tibet as a nation will rise again. We will free Tibet. United we stand, divided we fall. Pegalo! Pegalo! Pegalo!